New Zealand Opera is closing 2017 with Janacek's Katya, Kabonova, which has been transported to white picket-fenced 1950s America. And to share more about this tale of tragedy and human nature, please welcome to the Café two of the stars, James Benjamin Rodgers and Hayley Sugars. Welcome, guys. Yes. Welcome. Nice to have you along. I must say I'm unfamiliar with this particular opera. So, James, tell us a little bit more about the storyline. Katya seeking freedom from oppressive and repressive religious and social constraints. It sounds rather deep.
Yeah, it's pretty deep, but also pretty appropriate right now, I think, especially with its 1950s American setting. Mm. Yeah, she's a woman who is caught up in sort of a man's world in a lot of ways, and she doesn't quite... It's a very intimate story, and she doesn't know how to deal with it herself, so she has feelings that she knows aren't right, and she doesn't know what those feelings, where those will take her. So the story sort of, it tells the story of her arc in dealing with that and what the final outcome will be.
What role do you play within that?
I'm playing a character called Kudriash, who is a sort of free-thinking, progressive character, and is pretty much unlike all of the other characters in the show, except for Hayley's character, Varvara.
Varvara.
The names just roll off the tongue, don't they?
Yeah, they do. Varvara, Varvara is your lover.
That's
so
right.
What's Varvara like?
She's a young girl who, she's actually been adopted into her family, and she's really forward-thinking, just carefree, knows what she wants and wants to, you know, go for it, not feeling restricted by what she should be thinking, just goes with her emotions.
I think one of the great things about going to opera is, you know, the listening experience is incredible, there's a language experience, but visually too, often costumes are quite magnificent. I imagine in the 1950s, with 50s costume, it's going to look spectacular too, I guess.
Yeah, it's an incredible design actually that they've put together, the team that we have, and as I said, it feels very appropriate right now with what's been going on.
Mm-hmm. Oh, look at that! We're seeing some of those beautiful costumes on screen. Well, that's obviously not you. They must be phenomenal. Are they difficult to wear with the tight bodices? Do you have to change anything for those when you're singing?
My costumes in particular are very comfortable to wear. Easy to move in. I'm really lucky. I have very groovy costumes, I must say.
It's opera and you do have to be able to sing. So it was originally set in 1920s, wasn't it? But it's been transported to 50s America. Does that change the way the whole opera works?
Look, I think the underlying themes and emotions, you know, they sort of can be slotted into any era, but it particularly works well in the 1950s. And yeah, it's just really easy to access. The themes and the issues are very relevant to everyone. I'm sure you'll relate to them.
It's a universal story, like all great pieces. I think it is a great work in that way, and the story is relevant pretty much any time. This has been an issue people have been dealing with.
Yeah. We normally expect opera to be in the likes of Italian, but you are singing in Czech. That must come with its own challenges, right?
Sure does.
Yeah, it has been a interesting experience, but actually I've really come to like singing in Czech, and we had a great language coach, and of course, you know, we had to put in a lot of effort and a lot of study to know what we're singing about.
Can you think of some phrases? You don't have to sing them, but say them or sing them. Director's asking me to ask an opera singer to sing them.
Zazrak, vskutku trzeba žiti, že zazrak.
Okay, again, rolls off the tongue.
See, because the thing is, too, is that with opera, you're acting it as well as just singing, so you can't just learn lines verbatim and not know what they mean. You have to portray that as well in Czech.
Yeah. Mm. Actually, the hardest thing is being to be aware of what everybody else is saying.
Yeah.
That's really been the challenge, because...
Wouldn't have even thought about that.
Learning, you know, you have half, or not even, you know, 10% of the lines that are actually happening while you're on stage, so you have to be, like, going through in your mind.
It's very obvious. Very obvious if you're sort of standing there, you know, smiling at someone when they're talking about
tragedy, death, destruction.
Something. Yeah, so a lot of work, but it's really rewarding, and, you know, obviously the music was written in that language, and so it fits so well.
Yeah. For people looking for a bit of an on-ramp to opera, there is, you can help us, right, if we don't speak Czech, because I'm guessing a portion of the audience that do is quite small.
Yes, well, we have the surtitles above the stage, so you know exactly what's going on. And we're probably biased, but we think the production is, you know, it's very clear what's going on. And the music reflects the emotions so well. Like, it's really quite an amazing experience.
Wow, oh, it sounds exciting. Good luck, and it sounds like, you know, maybe you need to go to Czechoslovakia. Oh, it's not Czechoslovakia, the Czech Republic now, and practice out your language, see how you go. You'll be forward. Thank you both so much for joining us.
Thank you.
Now, the New Zealand opera season of Katya Kabonova opens this Saturday at the ASB Theatre in Auckland, and we'll then head to Wellington to the St James Theatre from 7th of October. For details, you can go to nzopera.com.